ओके, एज आई हैव आस्क्ड यू इन द लास्ट लेक्चर टू लर्न दी हाफ रिमेनिंग लेसन, लेसन नंबर 4 ऑफ हिस्ट्री, दैट इज द फ्रीडम स्ट्रगल ऑफ 1857. हाफ ऑफ द पार्ट वी हैव कंप्लीटेड रिविजन इन द लास्ट लेक्चर एंड हाफ ऑफ द पार्ट आई हैव आस्क्ड यू टू रिवाइज. ओके, सो आई एम गोइंग टू डिरेक्टली आस्क द क्वेश्चन टूडे. यस, am I clear? Should I ask the questions directly or you again want the revision? Yes, please make it clear. Should I ask you the questions directly? Okay, yes, so let's start. Yes, I have asked you to learn this lesson because only half of the lesson was remained revision only. Okay, revision was remaining. Okay, so let's thoroughly go through this. Okay, so we have learned about the political causes, then the discontent among the Indian soldiers, how it is formed, the discontent, why the Indian soldiers were unhappy with the British cause. They were paid less compared to the British soldier, and the allowances were also gradually decreased. And because of these reasons, the Indian the discontent rises among the Indian soldiers. Okay, then what were the immediate causes? Immediate causes: the sepoys were there were many Indian sepoys in the British army. Okay, and they were provided with the long Enfield rifles, and for this they required to bite the end of the cartridges, and one news was spread among that these sepoys was the cartridges were smeared in the fats of cow and pig. And due to this reason, the religious sentiments of Hindu and Muslim sepoys were hurt, and them it made them unhappy. This was the immediate cause. The outburst, what was the outburst included? See, Mangal Pandey from Barakpur cantonment shot an English officer as a reaction to unjust nature of British officer. Why did Mangal Pandey in the Barakpur cantonment shot an English officer? Because the sepoys who refused to use the smeared cartridges were given severe punishment. Ja shipayani tya cartridges la bite karnacha refuse kela, tanni virodh kela tya cartridges la, tanna काही पनिशमेंट देण्यात आली. म्हणून बराकपूर छावणीतील मंगल पांडे यांनी इंग्लिश ऑफिसरची हत्या केली. ओके, मंगल पांडे वॉज अरेस्टेड अँड हँग टू डेथ. मग नंतर मंगल पांडेंना पकडून फाशी देण्यात आली, आणि ही बातमी आगीसारखी सगळीकडे पसरली. त्यामुळे जे सैनिक होते, शिपाई होते, ते लढाईमध्ये उतरले. स्कोप ऑफ द स्ट्रगल, कुठून कुठे पसरलेला होता हा लढा? द रिवॉर्ड सून स्प्रेड इन नॉर्थ इंडिया. Okay, then Bihar to Rajputana, and then in Lucknow, Allahabad, Kanpur, Banaras, Bareilly, and Jhansi. Okay, it was also spread in the Satpura region. Now, leadership of struggle. Every struggle requires a leader. Okay, to lead them. So who did this leadership during 18th century? After weakening of Mughal Empire, invaders like Nadir Shah, Abdali attacked India. Marathas understood that Mughal Empire cannot react to this foreign invasion and took up responsibility of safeguarding India. पहिल्यांदा कोणी पुढाकार घेतला? मराठा सरदारांनी पुढाकार घेतला. ओके, देन the freedom struggle of 1857, the descendant of Mughal, Bahadur Shah, was incapable of fighting against British. Understanding this condition, Nana Saheb Peshwa, Rani Lakshmi Bai of Jhansi, and Tatya Tope took up the charge to charge. Okay, took up the charge. Then Maulvi Ahmad Allah Kuwar Singh, Mughal commander Bakht Khan, Begum Hazrat Mahal lead the revolt in various regions. Okay, crushing of struggle. What causes the crushing of struggle? The Indian wholeheartedly fought against this British, including soldiers, zamindar, kings, commanders, and common people also. Okay, but the military military strength of British were so high, okay? The British rule was so vast, and the British crushed down the struggle by all of the means. The British made quick recovery within the next 6 months, and they regained all the territories they lost during this war. Rani Lakshmibai, Kuwar Singh, Ahmadullah led their lives, and this was very favorable condition for British. Then they imprisoned Bahadur Shah, Nana Saheb, and Begum Hazrat Mahal, took shelter in Nepal. Tata Tope fought for next 10 months against the British, but due to the betrayal, he was caught and hanged to the death. In this way, by the end of 1858, British ruthlessly crushed down the struggle. Okay. See, the struggle began with the discontent among Indian soldiers, but later the peasant, artisan, common people, tribes, they all come together to fight against the British. In this condition, in this revolt, Hindu Muslims stood up in unity. Okay, they stood up in unity, and there was an inspiration of gaining independence behind this struggle among all of them. But why this struggle get failed? What was the causes? The struggle was not comprehensive. Okay, it did not take place simultaneously all over India. It was like in some places at some time and the other places at some different time. Okay, lack of central leadership. There was not a central leader to carry out this struggle. Most of the feudatory princes remained aloof. जी काही राष्ट्र होती, काही राज्य होती, ती या गोष्टींपासून विलुप्त राहिली. त्यामध्ये त्यांनी भाग घेतला नाही. लॅक ऑफ मिलिटरी टॅक्टिक्स. ब्रिटिशांकडे आर्मी ही खूप स्ट्रॉंग होती. आपले सोल्जर ब्रेव होते. ओके, ब्रेव होते, पण ब्रिटिशांकडे काय होती, ब्रिटिशांच्या मिलिटरीमध्ये स्ट्रॅटेजीचा वापर केला जायचा. दे वेर व्हेरी स्ट्रॅटेजिक. ओके, दॅट्स वाय वी लूज दिस वॉर अगेन्स्ट ब्रिटिश. ओके, देन इंटरनॅशनल सिच्युएशन वॉज ऑल्सो फेवरेबल फॉर ब्रिटिशर्स. द इंटरनॅशनल कंट्रीज वेअर ऑल्सो इन द फेवर ऑफ ब्रिटिश ओनली. दे वेर नॉट इन द फेवर ऑफ इंडिया. सो वॉट वॉज द क्वीन्स प्रोक्लेमिनेशन? क्वीन विक्टोरिया ऑफ इंग्लंड इश्यू अ डिक्लेरेशन एड्रेसिंग द पीपल ऑफ इंडिया दॅट All Indians are our progeny. Henceforth, they will not be discriminated on the basis of race, religion, caste, or birthplace. Government services will be given on merit. There will not be interference of religious affair. It was made clear that the British Crown will honor all treaties and agreements made by the company with the ruler of princely states, and no princely state will be annexed henceforth. Okay, जे काही संस्थानं होती ती खालसा केली जाणार नाही. ब्रिटिश धार्मिक धार्मिक भारतीयांच्या धार्मिक गोष्टींमध्ये हस्तक्षेप करणार नाही, आणि सगळी भारतीयाची जनता ही आता आमची जनता आहे असेच. आणि जे काही गव्हर्नमेंट जॉब असतील ते मेरिटच्या बेसिसवर दिले जातील. धर्म, जात, जन्माचं ठिकाण या कोणत्याही गोष्टींमध्ये भेदभाव केला जाणार नाही, असा जाहीरनामा राणी विक्टोरिया, इंग्लंडच्या राणी विक्टोरियाने जाहीर केला. चेंज इन कंपोजिशन ऑफ आर्मी. मग परत असा उठाव होऊ नये म्हणून काय काय करण्यात आलं? देर वॉज डिव्हिजन ऑफ मिलिटरी ऑन बेसिस ऑफ कास्ट. प्रॉपर केअर वॉज टेकन टू अवॉइड इंडियन्स टू युनाइट युनाइट अँड रिबेल अगेन अगेन्स्ट द ब्रिटिश. ओके, सी काय करण्यात आलं, एकत्र हिंदू मुस्लिम येणार नाही याची खूप काळजी घेण्यात आली. कास्टच्या बेसिसवर आर्मीच्या तुकड्या वेगवेगळ्या करण्यात आल्या, आणि परत ते सैनिक एकत्र येऊ नये आणि त्यांनी उठाव करू नये याची सगळी काळजी ब्रिटिशांनी घेतली. चेंज इन पॉलिसी. व्हॉट पॉलिसीज वॉज चेंज? द ब्रिटिश ऍक्सेप्टेड द पॉलिसी ऑफ नॉन इंटरफिअरन्स इन सोशल अँड रिलिजियस ऍस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ इंडिया इंडियन्स. भारतीयांच्या सामाजिक आणि धार्मिक बाबतींमध्ये हस्तक्षेप करणार नाही ही पॉलिसी ब्रिटिशांनी मान्य केली. दे ऑल्सो स्टार्टेड टेकिंग केअर दॅट द इंडियन सोसायटी विल नॉट बी युनायटेड ऑन सोशल ग्राउंड्स They saw it too that there will be constant conflicts on ground of caste, religion, race, territory, etc. पण ते या गोष्टींवर थांबले नाहीत. धर्माच्या जातीच्या नावावरून भारतीयांमध्ये एकमेकांमध्ये भांडणं होत राहतील याची त्यांनी पूर्णपणे दखल घेतली, पूर्णपणे काळजी घेतली आणि ती भांडणं ते लावतच राहिले. दे अडॉप्टेड द पॉलिसी ऑफ पोल्युटिंग द माइंड्स ऑफ इंडियन बाय फॉलोइंग डिवाइड अँड रूल पॉलिसी. मग सगळे एकत्र आले तर ते आपल्या विरुद्ध उठाव करणार हे त्यांना माहिती होतं. मग आता त्यांनी कोणती पॉलिसी कन्सिडर केली? डिवाइड अँड रूल, सगळ्यांना फोडा आणि राज्य करा, ही पॉलिसी त्यांनी रूल केली. ओके, नाव वेदा, दिस एक्सप्लेनेशन वॉज ओनली ड्यू टू युअर रिक्वेस्ट. ओके, सो आय एम एक्सपेक्टिंग आन्सर्स फ्रॉम यू. येस, एम आय क्लिअर? येस, सो यू शुड आन्सर द क्वेश्चन. Because everyone was like, no revision is required. They were just comfortable with question, but you only asked me to revise. So I'm expecting the answers from you. You also, okay? Yes. Okay, after the struggle of 1857, you have to write the answer in chat box for this. After the struggle of 1857, the post of dash dash was created in the British government to look after the affairs of India. Umaji Naik, War of Independence, Lord Dalhousie, Secretary of State, Tatya Tope. Yes, Secretary of State. Yes, Mansi, will you read the sentence along with answer?
Oh, yes, teacher. After the struggle of 1857, the post of Secretary of State was created in the British government to look after the affairs of India.
Yes. Your question number four is, Dash Dash was the Governor General who annexed the princely state. Who was the Governor General who annexed the princely state? Yes, Veda, will you answer this question? Veda, put on your mic and read the answer with question. Yes. Yes, Rudra, please.
Yes, Miss, Lord Dalhousie was the Governor General who annexed the princely states.
Okay. Next, explain the following statement with reason. You have to give a reason, okay? There was discontent among the Hindu and Muslim sepoys. You can just raise your hand. There was, yes, Nidhi.
Yes, ma'am. There was disconnected among the Hindu and Muslim
discontent.
Discontent among the Hindu and Muslim sepoys. In 1856, the British introduced long infinite rifles. The soldiers were required to buy the grease colored of the rifles to open them. The news spread among the soldiers that covering of a cartridge contained the fat of cows and sheep. The religious sentiments of the Hindu and Muslim soldiers were hurt and there was disconnect among them.
Okay. Next question is, the Indian sepoys could not keep stand in front of British army. What was the reason behind that? Yes, Marcy?
Yes, teacher. The Indian sepoys could not keep stand in front of the British army because the Indian soldiers were brave, but they had no military strategies. They did not have economic strength. Indians did not have latest and enough stock of arms and experienced army generals like the British. On the other hand, the British possessed the modern means of transport and communication and were therefore swift in their movement. This proved that the wars are not fought only on bravery but also through military strategies.
Yes. After this struggle, Indian army was divided on the basis of caste. Yes, Rudra?
Yes, Miss. There was a division of military on the basis of caste because the British felt that if the Indians came together, they would again unite and rebel against the British rule. Hence, proper care was taken by dividing them on the basis of caste to avoid future conflict.
Yes. Next, the British imposed heavy taxes on Indian industries. Yes, Nidhi?
Yes, ma'am. The British introduced new revenue system with the sole purpose to increase their income. The taxes were forcibly collected from farmers. British goods were sold in India to gain profits. They imposed heavy taxes on the goods made by local industries. This trade policy ruined India handicraft and textile industries. Many artisans became unemployed. The British imposed heavy taxes on Indian industries with the sole purpose to ruin the Indian economy.
Yes. Their main purpose was to ruin the Indian economy. Answer the following questions in brief. What were the social causes behind the struggle of 1857? The social causes you have to answer. What were the social causes? Yes, Rudra? Sure.
Yes, Miss. The social causes behind the struggle of 1857 were that the Indians felt that British interfered in their culture, traditions, and customs. And also, the British enacted Sati Prohibition Act and Widow Remarriage Act. These were seen as an interference in the lifestyle of the Indians. Indians resented it as it was regarded as the destruction of the way of life by the British government.
Yes. Next question is, why did the Indian fail in the struggle of 1857? Yes, Mansi?
Yes. There are several reasons for the failure of Indians in the struggle of 1857. They were, it did not have central leadership, so lacked uniformity. The Indian soldiers who participated in the struggle did not have latest and sufficient weapons. They were brave but did not have tactics. On the other hand, the British had a unified leadership, disciplined army, latest weapons and experienced army generals. The British controlled transport and communication, which made their movements swift. The majority of the rulers of the princely state kept themselves away from the freedom struggle. The struggle was served in northern India. It did not take place all over India simultaneously. Rajputana, Punjab, some parts of Bengal and northwest India remained aloof.
Yes, these were some causes due to which Indians fell in the struggle of 1857. Okay, next. Write down the consequences of struggle of 1857. What were the consequences? Chinmayi, please answer this question. What were the consequences of struggle of 1857? Yes, Chinmayi. Yes, you can read this para. Yes, put on your mic and read this whole para. Yes, Chinmayi, are you there?
Yes.
Please read this paragraph.
Due to Camper rule, there was growing dissatisfaction among the Indians, and the British rule had
had to face the struggle of struggle of 1857 it forced the British
parliamentally
to end the rule of the company and take over the responsibility of ruling over the people of India. Together, Government of India Act 1858, the government.
Okay, stop. Yes, who will answer this question? What were the consequences of struggle of 1857? Okay, Nidhi.
Yes, ma'am.
The British government realized that there was growing dissatisfaction among the Indians due to company rule. The British Parliament passed the Government of India Act in 1858 and took over responsibility of ruling over people of India, thus bringing an end to company rule. The Queen issues a declaration addressing a people of India. The Governor General was designated as the
designated
as the Viceroy of India, a new post of secretary.
Viceroy of India.
A new post of Secretary of State was created to look after the affairs of India. The British changed the composition of army and its internal policies.
Yes. Next, what were the changes in British policy after the struggle of 1857? Yes, Nancy.
Yes. The British accepted the policy of non-interference in social and religious aspects of Indians. They took care that Indian society did not unite on social grounds. They took care to see that conflicts on grounds of caste, religion, dress, territory keep ranging. They points and polluted the minds of Indians by following the policy of divide and rule.
Okay. So here we are ending with our four lessons revision and the question answers also. Okay. Yes. So we will start today with our lesson number 2 of civics. Yes. Okay. Let's see what we have learned in our lesson number 1. It was a main introduction to our parliamentary system. Okay. In this lesson number 1, we have learned about our parliamentary system. The parliamentary system was of two types. Yes, there were some characteristics of Indian parliamentary system which we have learned. Then we have learned two types of government, parliamentary system of government and presidential system of government. Yes, this was this was all included in our lesson number 1. Okay, let's start today with our lesson number 2 of civics, that is the Indian parliament. भारताची संसद. ओके, दिस इज अ पार्लमेंट हाऊस. संसद भवन आहे. संसद भवनचं पिक्चर दिलेलं आहे तुम्हाला, विच इज सिच्युएटेड ॲट न्यू दिल्ली. ओके, नवी दिल्ली इथे संसद भवन आहे आपलं, त्याचं चित्र आहे. लेट्स स्टार्ट. वी हॅव स्टडीड दॅट द पार्लमेंट प्लेज अन इम्पॉर्टंट रोल इन पार्लमेंटरी सिस्टम ऑफ गव्हर्नमेंट. इन दिस चॅप्टर वी विल डिस्कस द पार्लमेंट ऑफ इंडिया. ओके, आपण लास्ट लेसन मध्ये काय पाहिलं होतं, पार्लमेंटरी सिस्टम ऑफ गव्हर्नमेंट असेल तर तिथे कशाचा कोणाचा रूल चालतं, पार्लमेंटचा रूल चालतं. बरोबर. मग आपल्या इंडियामध्ये काय आहे, पार्लमेंटरी सिस्टम आहे, त्यामुळे आपण इथे या पार्लमेंट ऑफ इंडियाचा अभ्यास करणार आहोत. ओके, व्हॉट वॉज वेअर इट इज
Okay. Name the country where there is a precedent system of government. Yes, write name of that country, precedent system of government. You can write in chat box. Yes, United States of America. Okay. Let's start with this. The Constitution of India has created the Parliament of India. Okay, Parliament ची निर्मिती कोणी केलेली आहे? कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडियाने, भारताच्या संविधानाने केलेली आहे. द लेजिस्लेचर ऍट द नॅशनल लेवल, दॅट इज द लेवल ऑफ द सेंट्रल गव्हर्नमेंट, इज कॉल्ड द पार्लामेंट. आपल्या नॅशनल लेवलवरचं केंद्र शासन, राष्ट्रीय पातळीवरचं केंद्र शासन म्हणजेच संसद किंवा पार्लामेंट. इट कन्सिस्ट ऑफ द प्रेसिडेंट अँड टू हाऊसेस ऑफ पार्लामेंट, लोकसभा अँड राज्यसभा. हे लक्षात ठेवायचं आहे. पार्लामेंट इज कन्सिस्ट ऑफ प्रेसिडेंट अँड टू हाऊसेस ऑफ पार्लामेंट. विच आर दोज? फर्स्ट इज लोकसभा अँड सेकंड इज राज्यसभा. ओके. आपल्या संसदेमध्ये राष्ट्रपती, दॅट इज प्रेसिडेंट, देन लोकसभा आणि राज्यसभा यांचा समावेश असतो. नेक्स्ट, दो प्रेसिडेंट इज अन इनसेपरेबल पार्ट ऑफ द पार्लियामेंट, ही और शी कॅनॉट पार्टिसिपेट इन द डिस्कशन इन आयदर ऑफ द हाऊस ऑफ पार्लियामेंट. सी, राष्ट्रपती हा महत्त्वाचा घटक आहे भारताच्या संसदेचा किंवा भारत इंडियन पार्लियामेंटचा, पण संसदेच्या असणाऱ्या दोन्ही सभागृहामध्ये उपस्थित राहून जे काही विचार विनिमय चालू आहेत तिथे त्याला किंवा तिला भाग घेता येत नाही. ओके. येस. सी, दो अ प्रेसिडेंट, राष्ट्रपती इज अ इम्पॉर्टंट पार्ट ऑफ अवर पार्लियामेंट, इंडियन पार्लियामेंट, बट ही और शी कॅनॉट पार्टिसिपेट इन द डिस्कशन ऑफ हाऊस, आयदर हाऊस, लोकसभा किंवा राज्यसभा यांच्या डिस्कशन मध्ये राष्ट्रपती भाग घेऊ शकत नाही. ओके. द टू हाऊसेस ऑफ द पार्लियामेंट आर कॉल्ड द लोकसभा अँड राज्यसभा. अँड व्हॉट आर दीज टू हाऊसेस? या सभागृहांना काय म्हणायचं? लोकसभा आणि राज्यसभा. लेट्स लर्न अबाउट लोकसभा. लोकसभा इज अ लोअर अँड द फर्स्ट हाऊस ऑफ द पार्लियामेंट ऑफ इंडिया. आपल्या भारतीय पार्लियामेंटचा, भारतीय संसदेचा सगळ्यात लोवेस्ट, कनिष्ठ आणि फर्स्ट, ओके, प्रथम सभागृह, फर्स्ट हाऊस म्हणजे लोकसभा. लोकसभा इज अ हाऊस ऑफ रिप्रेझेंटेटिव डिरेक्टली इलेक्टेड बाय द पीपल. लोकसभेत कोण असतं? कोण कार्य करतं लोकसभेमध्ये? आपण ज्यांना थेट निवडून दिलं आहे, आपण आपल्या वोटर्स वोटिंगमुळे, जे आपल्या वोट्समुळे जे निवडून आलेले आहेत ते कुठे कार्य करतात? लोकसभेमध्ये. हेन्स द लोकसभा इज कॉल्ड द फर्स्ट हाऊस. म्हणूनच लोकसभेला पहिलं सभागृह म्हणतात. ओके. द मेंबर्स ऑफ लोकसभा आर इलेक्टेड डायरेक्टली बाय पीपल फ्रॉम द टेरिटोरियल कॉन्स्टिट्युएन्सीज. सी, लोकसभेच्या निवडणुकीसाठी काय केलं जातं? एखाद्या एरिया, जसे वॉर्ड वॉर्ड निर्माण करतात, माहिती आहे ना तुम्हाला, वॉर्ड नंबर 10, वॉर्ड नंबर 9, आणि त्यामधनं वेगवेगळे उमेदवार उभे राहतात. येस. मग ती निवडणूक कुठली असते? लोकसभेची असते. येस. बघा, लोकसभेच्या निवडणुकीसाठी काय केलं जातं? वेगवेगळ्या रिजनमध्ये वॉर्ड निर्माण केले जातात आणि तिथून तेवढ्या रिजनसाठी कार्य करण्यासाठी काही उमेदवार निवडून दिले जातात. द टेन्युअर ऑफ लोकसभा इज 5 इयर्स. लोकसभेचा कार्यकाळ किती आहे? 5 वर्षाचा आहे. म्हणजेच लोकसभेच्या निवडणुका प्रत्येक 5 वर्षांनी होत असतात. द इलेक्शन टेक्स प्लेस आफ्टर एव्हरी 5 इयर्स. प्रत्येक 5 वर्षांनी लोकसभेच्या निवडणुका होतात. दीज इलेक्शन आर नोन एज जनरल इलेक्शन. ओके. या निवडणुकांना जनरल इलेक्शन म्हणजे सार्वत्रिक निवडणुका असं म्हटलं जातं. हाउएव्हर देर आर एक्झाम्पल्स वेन द लोकसभा वॉज डिझॉल्व बिफोर द कम्प्लिशन ऑफ 5 इयर्स. पण काही काही वेळास असं सुद्धा होतं की 5 वर्षांचा कालावधी पूर्ण व्हायच्या आधीच लोकसभा काय होते? डिझॉल्व म्हणजे विसर्जित होते. बर्खास्त केले जाते. इलेक्शन्स हेल्ड इन सच अ केस आर कॉल्ड मिड टर्म इलेक्शन. मग अशा वेळी लोकसभेत उमेदवार राहत नाही, मग मध्येच इलेक्शन घ्यायला लागतात, निवडणुका घ्यायला लागतात. त्याला आपण काय म्हणायचं, मिड टर्म इलेक्शन, मध्यावधी निवडणुका. ओके, अंडरस्टूड टिल या? येस, अंडरस्टूड टिल या? ओके. लोकसभा इज द रिप्रेझेंटेटिव्ह बॉडी ऑफ सिटीजन्स ऑफ द कंट्री. आपल्या देशातील लोकांचं प्रतिनिधित्व करणारा सभागृह म्हणजे लोकसभा. ॲज पर द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन देअर कॅन बी अ मॅक्झिमम ऑफ 552 मेंबर्स इन लोकसभा. मग आपल्या संविधानानुसार, आपल्या कॉन्स्टिट्यूशननुसार लोकसभेत किती सदस्य असले पाहिजेत? 552. ओके, 552 मेंबर्स किंवा सदस्य लोकसभेत असू शकतात. टू एन्श्युअर इक्वल रिप्रेझेंटेशन टू ऑल सेक्शन्स ऑफ द कम्युनिटी, सम सीट्स आर रिझर्व फॉर मेंबर्स बिलॉंगिंग टू शेड्यूल कास्ट अँड शेड्यूल ट्राईब्स. बघा, आपल्या देशातील आपल्या देशात वेगवेगळ्या प्रकारचे जाती धर्माचे लोक राहतात. ओके, त्यापैकी काही शेड्यूल्ड कास्ट आणि शेड्यूल्ड ट्राईब्सच्या आहेत, काही अनुसूचित जाती आणि अनुसूचित जमातीची लोक सुद्धा आहेत. मग ते पण आपल्या समाजाचा एक घटक आहेत, आपल्या समाजाचा भाग आहेत की नाही, मग त्यांना सुद्धा प्रतिनिधित्व मिळायला पाहिजे. म्हणून काय केलं जातं, त्यांचा त्यांना सुद्धा इक्वल हक्क, इक्वल रिप्रेझेंटेशन मिळावं म्हणून त्यांच्यासाठी काही सीट्स रिझर्व केल्या जातात. ओके, आरक्षण दिलं जातं. सम सीट्स आर रिझर्व फॉर मेंबर्स बिलॉंगिंग टू शेड्यूल कास्ट अँड शेड्यूल ट्राईब्स. इन केस देर आर नो रिप्रेझेंटेटिव्ह फ्रॉम द अँग्लो इंडियन कम्युनिटी, द प्रेसिडेंट कॅन अपॉइंट टू मेंबर्स फ्रॉम दिस कम्युनिटी टू द लोकसभा. बघा, अँग्लो इंडियन समाजाला पुरेसं प्रतिनिधित्व नाही मिळालं तर त्या समाजाच्या दोन प्रतिनिधींची नेमणूक राष्ट्रपती स्वतः लोकसभेवर करू शकतो. ओके, कोणी त्यांना वोट्स नाही मिळाले किंवा पण जास्त त्यांना जास्त वोट्स नाही मिळाले निवडून येण्यासाठी, पण त्यांच्यासाठी सीट रिझर्व केलेल्या आहेत. मग ती सीट कशी भरणार? तर राष्ट्रपती स्वतः काय करतो, जेवढे मेंबर्स आहेत त्या समाजाचे त्याच्यातून इलिजिबल मेंबर्सला, दोन मेंबर्सला, इलिजिबल दोन मेंबर्सला ती जागा देऊन टाकतो. ओके, अंडरस्टूड अबाउट लोकसभा? येस, अंडरस्टूड अबाउट लोकसभा? ओके, शुड आय आस्क द क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन दॅट? वेअर इज इंडियाज पार्लमेंट पार्लमेंट हाऊस सिच्युएटेड? Where is India's Parliament House? You can write the answer in chat box. Yes? Where it is? New Delhi. Yes. Who created our parliament? Who created Indian parliament? Yes. Who created our parliament? Indian parliament was created by whom? Yes, what happened? No one?
Miss?
Yes?
You said elected or created?
Created. I'm asking about parliament. Who created Indian parliament? Yes, Rudra?
Yes, Miss, the Constitution of India has created the Indian Parliament.
Yes. How many houses are there in Indian Parliament and their names? How many houses are there in Indian Parliament and what are their names? You can raise your hand. Yes, Nidhi.
Yes, ma'am. There are two houses of Parliament, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha.
Okay, yes. Who is, okay, listen it very carefully. Who is the inseparable part of Parliament? Okay, name the person who is the inseparable part of Parliament, but it could not take part in the discussion of Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. Who is that person? You can write it in the chat box only. Yes, president. That person is president. Yes. Which is the first and lower house of the Indian Parliament? First and lower house of the Indian Parliament? Yes, Mansi?
Lok Sabha.
Yes. Why the Lok Sabha is called the first house of Parliament? Why Lok Sabha is called as first house of Parliament? Yes, who will answer this question? Please raise your hands. Mansi, would you like to answer this question?
Yes, miss.
Yes.
The Lok Sabha is the lower and the first house of the Parliament of India. Lok Sabha is the House of Representatives directly elected by the people. Hence, the Lok Sabha is called the first house.
Okay. What was the tenure of Lok Sabha? For how many years a Lok Sabha can work? A particular candidates in Lok Sabha can work. Yes, Rudra?
Yes, Miss. 5 years.
Yes, 5 years. How many members are there in the Lok Sabha? Yes, Mansi?
552 members are there in Lok Sabha.
Yes. Sorry. Why are there some seats reserved for scheduled caste and scheduled tribes? Yes. Why there are some seats are reserved in Lok Sabha for scheduled caste and scheduled tribes? What is the reason behind that? Yes, Nidhi?
Yes, ma'am. To ensure representation to all sections of the society, some seats are reserved for members belonging to scheduled caste and scheduled tribes.
Tribes, yes. For ensuring their equal representation to all sections. Okay. How many members can a president appoint from the Anglo-Indian community? Yes, Rudra?
Yes, Ms. The President can appoint 2 members from the Anglo-Indian Committee.
Okay. See. The constituent states in India get seats on basis of their population. For the purpose of election, the state is divided into territorial constituencies. The population of these territorial constituencies is approximately equal. Use the internet to find out the number of seats each constituent state has in the Lok Sabha. For example, Maharashtra 48 seats, Gujarat, मध्य प्रदेश एंड गोवा वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट. बघा जी काही घटक राज्य आहेत त्यांच्या लोकसंख्या किती आहे त्यांच्याकडे त्यावरून तिथे लोकसभेच्या जागा मिळतात. ओके मग निवडणुकीसाठी काय केलं जातं प्रत्येक राज्याला जसं मी सांगितलं वॉर्ड करतात तसं वेगवेगळ्या मतदारसंघात डिवाइड करतात. ओके आणि मतदारसंघाची लोकसंख्या साधारणपणे सगळीकडे सारखीच असते. आता वेगवेगळ्या जे राज्य आहेत त्यांना लोकसभेमध्ये किती जागा दिल्या आहेत ते इंटरनेट मधून आपल्याला शोधून काढायचं आहे. अँड यू आर गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट दिस. ओके महाराष्ट्र आर रिझर्व 48 सीट्स इन द लोकसभा अँड गुजरात मध्य प्रदेश अँड गोवा यू हॅव टू फाइंड आउट. ओके विल यू डू दॅट? येस. Okay, so whatever you have learned today from this, you can you tell me the features of Lok Sabha, characteristics or features of Lok Sabha, or if I ask you to write a note on Lok Sabha, what you will write in that? Do not read directly, just tell me what you have understood. Yes, Rudra, you want to answer this question?
Yes, Miss, I will say main points only.
Okay.
Lok Sabha is the lower and the first house of the parliament. It is consisting of maximum 552 members. It is directly elected by the people from territorial constituents. In case of Anglo-Indian committee is not adequately represented, the president can also appoint two members from the community to Lok Sabha. Some seats are reserved for scheduled caste and scheduled tribes. The tenure is 5 years. General elections held after every 5 years, and members must have completed 25 years of age to contest.
Okay, good. Yes, anyone else? Ajun koni denar ka yacha answer? Rudra has explained it very well, but anyone else wants to answer this again? Okay, so now tell me the parliament house, about the parliamentary system of India or about the parliament of India. Yes, what you have understood that you have to tell me in this lesson, what you have understood about the parliament of India. And if they ask you to write a note on Parliament of India, what you will write on that? Okay, Rudra, you again want to answer this question also?
Yes, I have one point only from this lesson, that Parliament is the legislature at the national level is called Parliament, and it consists of the President, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. The President, yes, cannot participate in the discussion of either of the house or the parliament. The constitution of India has created the parliament of India.
Yes, fine, that was only expecting. Okay,
excuse
so
me.
So understood. Yes,
Miss, I have found it from internet that Gujarat is having 26 seats.
Okay, good. Yes, good. Okay, so whatever I have told you or whatever I have taught you till now, have you understood it very clearly? Tell me. I'm not starting the next topic, Rajya Sabha, because we do not have that much time. And if I start it in the next lecture, we will also have to revise and it will break our link, okay? So I'm not going to start Rajya Sabha today. So you have clearly understood? Tell me. Yes. Okay, so we are going to stop here for today. Your question will be posted on your Google Classrooms, but I'm just explaining over here that your questions will be like, you have to write about Lok Sabha and the Parliament of India. Yes, and you are going to find out these two, the seats which are available according to the territorial constituencies, which are how many seats are allotted to Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh and Goa. Yes, you will find that. Tell me, you will find that. And can you write about Lok Sabha and the Parliament of India also? Yes, so I will post these questions only on your Google Classroom. You have to write them. Okay, so for today, we are going to stop over here. You can leave now.
Bye, Miss. Thank you, Miss.
Bye. Welcome.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye, Miss. Thank you, Miss.
Bye.